Hey everybody, it's Paul, and I'm back with more Majora's Mask. In the last episode, we went through the stupid-ass well, and in this episode, this is the second take, because the first take of this episode went so fucking bad, I can't even believe- I didn't even finish the episode, because I was just being so stupid. So stupid! Oh, get your cursor off the screen, you idiot. Like, ugh. There's an area coming up with, like, a really annoying passageway that you have to go through to get on top of it. And I had to go through that area 3 times on camera. We got the mirror shield, by the way. This thing is really spooky looking. This allows us to focus, like, direct light in a beam in front of us to, like, light up stuff. You can use it on these sun things here. And they light up all spookily, scarily, and craxily. Make a thing appear, and then I bump the bottom of my desk with my controller because I'm just awful. Yeah, it's like, this next area is, to be honest, really fucking confusing. Like, the design of it is just so obtuse, and like, all the walls look the same. Like, the music's good, but it's also kind of repetitive, so I don't know if it's even that good. It's just a disaster. Not to mention, you know, you need fire arrows. You want to have your arrows equipped all the time. Because the enemies you encounter in there are all weak to arrows, and you get cursed half the time. But you need, like... Well, I guess I don't need the captain's hat. But, yeah, so you come up the other end of the well, and this is the ancient castle of Ikana. Hoo-la! About time we finally made our way here. Yeah, see what I mean? Like, this whole area, it's got that symmetrical confusion where you aren't entirely sure which side something is happening on because both sides look pretty much the same. And it's really easy to accidentally balls this up and need to do an entire segment over. But anyway, you come in the front door and you enter the first room, and right away there's like 4 redets right here. But if you put the captain's hat on, they start dancing like dumbasses. Then you can just stand in the middle of them and do a couple spin attacks in a row. And they all die horribly. And I couldn't be happier. And the worst part is that my tonsils are flaring up because I've been talking for too long. It's like the back of my throat is just all swollen shut and gross. And it feels... It's like that kind of swollen where it feels cold. And it's got like... It just feels like something... Like too much friction going on between different parts of my mouth. And the and something else that's really annoying about this is that I need to get a powder keg to complete this area, but I don't have a powder keg, so I need to open up the front door. If I had a powder keg, I could sequence break the fuck out of this, but obviously I don't. Fuck you! Fuck you! Fuck you! So hard! Oh, hate you so much. Anyway. You hit the switch and the ceiling raises up, and what you want to do is you want to get to one of these Deku flowers, get into it, and then hide. Now, you might think, oh, I'm going to get crushed, but don't worry, because once the ceiling comes down, you can actually use the Deku flower to knock it back up to the ceiling. And then, you just need to make it on top of this pillar here, push this button, which you need to actually change back into a human to do, because the Deku isn't heavy enough, which is also pretty annoying. Then you can, thankfully, you can make that jump pretty easily. Come in here, and now you need to get out your damn lens of truth, and also switch to regular arrows because you can't use fire arrows while you have the lens of truth equipped. So you gotta switch to that. It's like the stuff you need to get through this area is so varied that you can't, and it's almost impossible to get through here without needing to change what you have equipped at least once. I mean, I could have taken off the captain's hat, so I could have had, like, Lens of Truth, Deku, Mask, and Arrows. That probably would have worked, but, and then there's this room, where if you aren't, like, right away rolling between those guys, they almost always curse you, so you can't use your sword once you get up on the roof. Which means you gotta fight the Guays up here with arrows, which is a good way to fight them anyway, but it's still a pain in the ass. Oh, come on, I can get this guy. Oh, come on, I can get this guy. I know I can. Get him! Get him! There you go. Only took 15 fucking shots. Okay, but now that we're up here, There's some shit we can do, but first we gotta put the damn Deku mask back on our hotbar. And we also gotta kill this guy or else he's gonna be causing problems for us. Because we gotta come down here to this Deku flower. Put on our Deku mask, you know, put on your gas mask! And get over here. So you can push this switch. Which switch is which? Well, this one moves a random block on a spot that's like, where is that? I don't know. But it's actually on that side. On that side. That's right above the door we didn't go through from the room with all the re-deads. There's two rooms that we could have gone to. Two doors we could have taken from that room with all the re-deads. And that door goes to the... And that, that block that just moved unblocked a hole above the room that door would have led us to on the right. So what that does is once we go back inside, you know, once we go back inside, there'll be a little focused tunnel of light in that room. And this is what caused me to, this is what caused all the failage. Because what happened was I didn't realize where the block was. I thought, because here's the thing, I need to get a powder keg to be able to finish this area. But to get a powder keg in here, unless you already had one beforehand, which would be some, like, grade A foresight, unless you'd already played this game before, like I have and just didn't think of, you have to get rid of that block right there to be able to easily travel between this and the rest of Ikana Canyon. But in order to do that, you need to get a beam of light going, you need to get some focused light coming out of the castle, so that you can actually fire a beam of light into that cube. Now what happened was, when I moved that block by pressing that switch, I thought it was going to uncover something that would allow me to get rid of that block. But it doesn't. It just gets rid of, it uncovers a hole leading down into the room on the right. And what happened was I went through that area that I went through to get on top of the roof here. I went through that area three times. The first time, I got the heart piece and then fell down and then jumped down like a dumbass and then realized, oh shit, I needed to stay up there. The second time, I pushed that switch and then jumped down because I was actually supposed to jump down at that point. But then I came back up to the top because I thought there was more I could do up there, but there actually wasn't. So I did two extra trips up there that I didn't need to do, which was really stupid. But now that we've moved that block, we can come in here, and there's actually, like, a light here. There's also a wall master in here that you can pretty much wreck to pieces with the, the great thing about the mirror shield is that you can use it to pretty much instantly KO any undead enemy just by shining light at them. Which is very convenient, and there's some more dancing re-deads behind this block. What are these guys doing? One of them's doing the fucking can-can thing. What? But I think if you shine light far enough to hit those guys. But you can just walk through them, no problem. What are those two guys in the middle doing? Those guys look really goofy. What? A whiz robe? Oh, for crying out loud. You gotta be kidding me, man. Alright, just stand in the corner, basically. Get your bow out. Shoot him whenever he appears, no problem. You can use the stereo sound to tell where he's about to appear. So now he's about to appear over there. And he's not in his second phase yet, which is a bit surprising to me. I think he's doing it now though. Yeah. Now you just gotta figure out where the real one is. It's that one. Now, which one is the real one? It's that one. Now, which one is the real one? Oh, it's right in front of me! Okay. Now, which one is the real one? But which one is the real Gundren Rockseeker? Anyway, there you go. He's dead. Alright, who's next? Now we can head through here. Is this what I think it is? Or is this somewhere else? I think we're on our way up to the throne room. There's some more dancing re-deads. Can you imagine walking into that room and not having the captain's hat on? That would scare the living piss out of me. But anyway, see, now we're up on top of the roof again, and we can't do what we need to do in here, which is really annoying, because there's a hole, because we need a powder keg here. Take a look, the rocks are cracked here, but we can't get this open without a powder keg. But we don't have a powder keg, because why the hell would you think to bring a powder keg? Unless you'd already played this game before. But like, a bomb isn't enough? I don't think... I wonder if maybe a Goron pound would do it, but yeah, a bomb isn't enough. Unless it is. No, it's not enough. It shakes, but it's not enough to actually do the damage. It's not... It doesn't do the necessary damage. And that doesn't do anything. Get out of here, you fuck. Man, these blocks are really spooky. Like this one, they look like it's like a face. It's like a body curled into a ball. You see, but now I don't have a powder keg, so I can't actually do what I need to do here. So I gotta go all the fucking way back to town. You know, unsure of whether or not there's gonna be an easy way to get back here. Now, see, here's the thing, is that it's possible that there's a beam of light that I can direct at that block on the other side, like, on the actual Ikana Canyon side. Like, it's possible that I don't need to open the gate between here and Ikana and the main canyon area. It's possible I don't need to open it from this side, but that's a risk to actually, I'm taking a gamble when I fly away from here that's actually going to be the case. Which I don't know. But anyway, let's just put on the Goron mask. And, talk to this guy. Hello, sir! Give me a powder keg. Yeah. I can also deposit the rest of my rupees, because I got 450 of the fucking things, which is ridiculous. I don't know. Where did I even get all this money? It's ridiculous. Anyway, let's talk to the guy. Hello! Deposit rupees! Yes, 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 yes. We've been through this conversation a million times. Looks like we're about to break 300, so 450. Yeah. 3,036 rupees. Hooray. Now, is there anything else I want to do here? Oh, I see Anju. Hello, Anju. What are you doing? Talk to me. Talk to me, baby. Talk to me. Hello? Oh, she looks sad. Whoa. Just walked, like, right past me. Anyway. Let's play the song of Soaring, go back to Ikata Cantiad now that we have a powder keg. And hopefully we can open the way to Ikana Castle from this side, because we can't soar there. The only other soaring place in here is, as is the norm for these areas, right next to the dungeon. Can I actually go through here as a Goron? Yeah, I can. But yeah, you gotta come through here. Oh, boing. And please tell me there's a light here. Oh, there is light here. But see, this is what I was worried about, because I didn't know. How could I possibly know unless I'd played the game before? Which, I mean, I have. Oh, that is far enough. I just couldn't tell very well because the texture of my, the target of my thing blended in with the, It kind of blended in with the texture on the blocks. But see, now, we can get on top of the roof, we can actually blow open a hole in the ceiling, which will do the exact same thing that it did for us in this room, basically. Ow. One of my favorite things about the mirror shield is that it always reflects light, even when you're not, like, actively using it. So you can just, like, have it in your offhand, pointing forward, and just walk through a light and accidentally kill, like, a redead or something as you just walk through the room. Just hilarious. So now we're on top, and we can actually use the powder keg now. No, don't play music. I'm not used to having my, transformation mask equipped to that button. And just punch it. No, I can't do that. Okay, I hit with your sword. Can't do that either, gotta use a fucking arrow. Habuski. And we fall into the center of the room. Yeah, see, it's like, isn't that hilarious? Like, I wasn't even trying to do anything there. I just accidentally killed them because, because I had my shield out. I literally just walked and they all died, but now we can actually get rid of this block in the center here and proceed with the thing about BAHBULL as soon as I stop fucking saying that. I said that, like, so many times recently. Got on the thing about BAHBULL! 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 Anyway, so in here, we actually enter the throne room. Doesn't this look fanciful? And there's some rumbling. Oh, insolent one who has brought the unthinkable into a land as dark as Ikana. Uh-oh, the curtains are closing. My servants have fallen namelessly before the light that guides you. However, oh man, look at this badass. The darkness in which my servants live is, after all, fleeting. You shall see with your own eyes. Just what kind of thing true darkness really is! These things are so funny. Anyway, so yeah, you got these things, but something else funny that you can do here is you can actually put the captain's hat on. They're actually still attacking me? Okay, but if you run up to the king with the captain's hat on, he's like, oh, Kita! Is it not Captain Kita? But you're so tiny! I was nearly fooled by what you have done. He's just shaking his head. That's just such a silly scene. Anyway, so what you need to do here is you need to bust out your fire arrows. And actually just go right on ahead and try to get a shot off. Oh, it's really tricky to do this because they're not gonna stop attacking you. But see, now the light's pouring into the room. Ow. And we can just stun these guys like straight up. And we can bust open the other curtain, get some more light in here. Oh! I love how it's like this is supposed to be such a like a serious this is like supposed to be a serious scene, but it's just so funny. Like there's something so funny about these dorks. Now that we've gotten them down, we need to use the mirror shield to finish off their remains, and they die. Oh, but now he comes to life. Oh, look at this badass. Man, what a badass. Holy crap, what is this guy's name? Stick with using the basic target methods while defending. He's a different rank than those other two lackeys, though. But, still, just, nothing but a mortal. Anyway. Yeah, whatever, just... Ha 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 ha! Yeah, whatever. This guy's like a badass, though. Like, I would totally like to... What does he do? He just summoned a... He just split his head off! Oh, I can't actually hit that part of him anymore now. What the hell? I've never seen him do this before. That is so weird. Dude, you were standing in the light. That should have hurt you, man. Yes, even now. And just get... There you go. Huh. Mini-boss completed. And they die. Oh, but they're still alive, kind of. Alive in their undeath. You're blocking me! Get out of the way! I can still get him! Blocking you? The reason he beat us is because you were so feeble! Don't blame this on me! What? Just try saying that again to my bony face! Feeble! Feeble, 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 feeble! Shut up already! Don't look at me! I was once called the best swordsman in all of Ikana! The greatest husband in all of Ikana? You? Feeble. Draw your weapon! Huh? I'm telling you to draw your sword! This scene is hilarious. How? So happy. Like, what is this? Will you stop? What fools! Haven't you begun to understand? The kingdom being ruined and us left in this state. Isn't it petty little battles like this that have caused it? and they die for good. Which one of my ancestors did you just shame to death? Believing in your friends and embracing that belief by forgiving failure. These feelings have vanished from our hearts. It all happened after somebody thrust open the doors of that stone tower. You who bring light into darkness, I am the king of Ikana Kingdom. Igos du Ikana. Hua! The spellbinding that had been cast upon us was broken by that light which you carry. To return true light to this land, you must seal the doors of Stone Tower where the winds of darkness blow through. But Stone Tower is an impenetrable stronghold. Hundreds of soldiers from my kingdom would not even be able to topple it. It is far too reckless for one to take on such a challenge. And so, I grant to you a soldier who has no heart, one who will not falter in the darkness. You shall remember this song. This song is so spooky. Which one is down? Yeah. You play the Elegy of Emptiness. Are you ready for some true blue spoop? Because you're about to experience some true blue spoop. You learned the Elegy of Emptiness, alright. It's a mystical song that allows you to shed a shell shaped in your current image. By playing the song while wearing masks to assume different forms, you'll be able to leave up to 4 empty shells, one for each form! This soldier who has no heart is your twin image, a shell of yourself that you will shed when your song commands it. And he dies. On my kingdom, shine the light of justice. Alright, awesome. Oh, and the clock tower bell gongs out. Ugh, that's spooky. So, what do we do with all this new information? Find out next time on Let's Play Majora's Mask, where we enter the next dungeon. Kinda. It might take us an episode to get there. See you then. That's the right word. Then, not nen. Bye, guys.